Are you interested in getting into the music industry and don't know how? Are you a singer, songwriter, producer, or manager? Then you've made a very wise purchase today. Grab your pen and pad and get ready to absorb a wealth of information that will get you well on your way. As music industry coach, Lionel Green walks you through more than 20 years of industry experience. And now, here's 7 steps on how to put yourself into the music industry by Lionel Green.
Hello, my name is Lionel Green, CEO of BG Records. This is a very exciting day for you. Why? Because you are one step closer to putting yourself into the music industry. Let me tell you how. I have compiled 20 years of experience eliminating all of the bad mistakes that I have made into one powerful CD on a precise avenue, 7 steps to put yourself into the music industry. Are you ready to get started? Let's go.
Step 1, taking care of your business.
In my 20 years of being in the music industry, you would be shocked to know the percentage of how many people trying to do the same have never heard of companies such as BMI, ASCAP, CSEC, what about the Copyright Office in Washington, D.C., or Sound Exchange? People, wake up. That's like telling someone, I'm graduating from college next year, but in 4 years of being there, you have never registered. No one has your name on file. You sat in the back of lecture rooms, you've even taken exams, but in 4 years of doing all of this, your name isn't recorded anywhere. The dean says you're not a member of the university, therefore no credit has been issued to you, and at the age of 22, you're still just a high school graduate. Why, you ask? Because you have failed to take care of the necessary paperwork that could have landed you a student of the university, or better yet, a college degree. This is how it would be in the music business. Let's say you wrote some lyrics for a song. You gave it to a friend. He or she says, my cousin is on a record label. I think he or she would love this song. So your friend gives the song to their cousin. The cousin loves it and records it. The song becomes a major hit, sales soar to platinum status. You're all excited, but when the money starts coming in, you never receive a penny of it. Why? Once again, like you did in college, you failed to do the necessary paperwork to get credit for your work. All I'm saying, people, is take care of the necessary paperwork before getting into any kind of business. With all the resources out there now, it is pretty easy. Your first step of being part of the music industry is simply to pick up the phone and call BMI, CSEC, or ASCAP. Depending on where you're located, they have offices in New York, Tennessee, and Los Angeles. Or you can go onto their website, www.bmi.com or www.ascap.com, and download the necessary paperwork. Either way, get as much information as possible that you need to be informed of the best way of becoming a writer and or a publisher with their organization. Both BMI and ASCAP, as well as CSEC, are organizations that will pay you mechanical royalties every time your song is played on an AM or an FM radio station. As far as Sound Exchange, it allows artists to now get paid for their airplay on internet radio stations as well as satellite radio stations. I remember the first song my brother, sister, and I wrote. It was called In the Mood. We knew this was the next major hit for the year of 1985. I remember it like it was yesterday. The next day after completing it, my brother and I went to the barbershop downtown Detroit, got our hair cut, and put on our finest clothes, and off to the post office we went to put the tape in the mail, addressed to the Copyright Office in Washington, D.C. We thought this was it. Once the Copyright Office heard this song, we are going to be stars. Later we laughed. Once we found out that the Copyright Office only registers it. But what that did for us, it gave us ownership, negotiation power, something you didn't have after giving your song away with no proof that you wrote it. Although In the Mood was never released to the public, we still have the paperwork saying In the Mood belongs to Lionel, Gerard, and Rhoda Green. This is powerful, folks. I try to tell people around the country, protect your songs. We've all heard horror stories about people stealing other people's songs. Why? Because they did not do the proper paperwork to copyright and protect their songs, as well as publishing and writing. We've heard the story of the Beatles not owning any of the publishing of any of their work. Therefore, Michael Jackson bought all of the publishing to the Beatles' work. Wow. This is incredible that you can be the number one selling group in the world and not protect yourself with the use of publishing, writing, and copywriting. Now, let's review the major points of this section that you need to know to get you on your way. 1. Research both BMI and ASCAP to see which one you want to be a member of. 2. Make the call to your regional office or log onto their website, either BMI.com or ASCAP.com, to download the information. My suggestion would be to do both. Call to talk to a live voice and go onto the website to get your own understanding of what's needed. Also, at the same time, register with the Sound Exchange in Washington, D.C., or go on to their website, www.soundexchange.com. 3. Do not submit any material of any kind to anyone before getting your music, lyrics, or both registered at the Copyright Office in Washington, D.C. This will save you from a lot of problems that come up between friends and associates.
This concludes Step 1, Taking Care of Your Business.